today, class 10th is going to perform the flip learning on topic of decentralization in India. So let's begin.
Federalism isn't about the state's right. It is about dividing power to better protect individual liberty. Good morning, everyone. Today, we are going to start flip teaching on decentralization in India.
What is federalism? Federalism is a system of government in which power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of the country. A federation has two levels of government. Both these levels of government enjoy their power independent of the other. One is the government for the entire country that is usually responsible for a few subjects of the common national interest. Governments at the level of provinces or states that look after much of the day-to-day administrating of their state.
Decentralization in India. When power is taken away from central and the state government and given to the local government is called decentralization. The basic idea behind the decentralization is that there are a large number of problems and issues which can be settled at the local level. Local people can also directly participate in the decision making. A major step has been taken towards the decentralization in 1992. The constitution was amended to make the third tier of the democracy more powerful and effective. Today, I'm going to tell you some of the key features of the three-tier democracy. First, it is constitutionally mandatory to hold regular elections to local government bodies. Second, seats are reserved in the elected bodies and the executive heads of these institutions for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and other backward classes. Third, at least one third of the positions has been reserved for the women. Fourth, State Election Commission has been created in each state to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. At last but not least, the state governments are required to share some of the powers and the revenue with the local government bodies, and the nature of the sharing varies from state to state.
Panchayati Raj system. Rural local government is popularly known as Panchayati Raj. Each village or a group of villages in some states has a Gram Panchayat. This is a council consisting of several ward members, often called Panch, and a president or a Sarpanch. They are directly elected by all the adult population living in a village or ward. Gram Panchayat is a decision-making body for the entire village.
How panchayat system work? The panchayat works under the overall supervision of Gram Sabha, also known as village level. All the voters in the following village are its member. It has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year to approve a annual budget of the Gram Panchayat and to review the performance of the Gram Panchayat. When Gram Panchayat are grouped together, they form a panchayat samiti, also known as block level. The member of panchayat samiti representative are elected by all panchayat members in that area. All the panchayat samitis or mandals in a district together constitute the Zilla Parishad, also known as district level. Members of Lok Sabha, MLAs of the districts and other officials of other district level bodies are the member of Zilla.
Municipalities. As Gram Panchayat is for rural areas, similarly we have municipalities for urban areas. Big cities are constituted into municipal corporation. Both municipality and municipal corporation controlled by elected bodies consisting of people's representatives. The municipal chairperson is the political head of the municipality. In the municipal corporation, such an officer is called as the mayor. This is the new system of local government, is the largest experiment in the democracy conducted anywhere in the world. Constitutional status for local government has helped to deepen democracy in our country. It has also increased women's representation and voice in our democracy.
At last but not least, we are going to tell you about the importance of the decentralization. First, rapid decision making. Second, administrative development. Third, development of executive skills. Fourth, promotes growth. And fifth, high control. Thank you.
A very warm and pleasant good morning to everyone. Today, I'm Shruti Jain of Class 10th B has given a golden opportunity to do flip teaching on decentralization in front of you all. What is decentralization? India is such a big country and its states are as big as independent countries of our world. So, to decrease the pressure from state government and for proper maintenance, a third tier of government is introduced, which is known as local government. So, when powers are taken away from central and state government and given to local government, it is called decentralization. Importance of decentralization. The basic idea behind decentralization is that there are a large number of problems and issues which are best settled at the local level. People have better knowledge of problems in their locality. They have better ideas on where to spend money and how to manage things more efficiently. Decentralization supports democracy. Through decentralization, it is possible for the people to directly participate in decision making. This helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation. Local government is the best way to realize one important principle of democracy. Direct rule of people. Steps for promoting decentralization. In 1992, amendments were made in constitution to promote decentralization. First, now it is a constitutionally mandatory to hold regular elections to local government bodies. Second, seats are reserved in the election bodies and the executive heads of these institutions for the SCs and STs and other backward classes. Third, at least one-third of all positions are reserved for women. Fourth, an independent institution called the State Election Commission has been created in each state to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. Fifth, the state government are required to share some powers and revenue with local government bodies. The nature sharing varies from state to state. Thank you.
Everyone standing in front of you, roll number 2 of class 10, and today I'll be going to elude my views through a flip teaching on the topic decentralization in India.
India is a vast country and it cannot run only through the two tiers of government. Many of the states are internally very diverse and there is thus a need for power sharing within these states. This further resulted in decentralization of power, thus resulted a third tier of government called the local government. So now the question arises, what really is decentralization? When power is taken away from central and state government and given to the local government, it is called decentralization. People have better knowledge of problems in their localities. They also have better ideas on where to spend money and how to manage things more efficiently. That's why the basic idea behind decentralization is that there are a large number of problems and issues which can be best settled at the local level. The need for decentralization was recognized in our constitution. That there have been several attempts to decentralize power to the level of villages and towns. Panchayats in villages and municipalities in urban areas were set up in all states. Local government did not have any powers or resources of their own. Thus, there was very little decentralization in effective terms. Now came the time to take the step towards decentralization. It was 1992 when the constitution amended to make the third tier of democracy more powerful and effective. Which means now it is constitutionally mandatory to hold regular elections to local government bodies. At least 1/3 of all positions are reserved for women. And seats are also reserved in elected bodies and executive heads of these institutions for the SCs, STs and other backward classes. Now let's know in brief about the local governments. The rural local government is popularly known by the name Panchayati Raj. Each village or group of villages have a Gram Panchayat. This Gram Panchayat is a council consisting of several ward members, which are called as Sarpanch, President or Panch. They are directly elected by all the adult population living in that area. It is the decision-making body for the entire village. Now how the Panchayat works. The Panchayat works under overall supervision of the Gram Sabha. All the voters in the village are its members. It has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year to approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat. The local government structure goes right up to the district level. A few Gram Panchayats, when grouped, are usually called a Panchayat Samiti or Mandal. The members of this representative body are elected by all the Panchayat members in that area. And these Panchayat Mandals together are called Zira Parishad. Not only in the villages, the local government bodies exist for urban areas as well. Municipalities are set in towns. Together, the municipalities and municipal corporations are controlled by elected bodies consisting of people's representatives. Thank you.